We've been making the case that the idea of feeling like a failure, feeling condemned, or feeling guilty has nothing to do with the normal biblical Christian life. That it's a religious misrepresentation, and it twists God to make him look like the mean and harsh and judgmental God that's very angry with people and angry with sin that we so often see replicated in the church world. But let me give you just one verse which you might have heard before in a different version that kind of clarifies all this for us. Paul is talking about the struggle he has. It's in Romans 7, where he's kind of wanting to do what's right, but he can't. There's this accusing voice of condemnation all the time. And then we get to 8 verse 1. Listen to this. So now the case is closed. There remains no accusing voice of condemnation against those who are joined in life union with Jesus, the Anointed One. The case is closed. There remains no condemning voice. If you're hearing condemning voices, you simply haven't been clearly instructed on the fact that that case is closed. If you're in life union with Jesus, which is what being born again is, which is really what a Christian is, then that voice has been finished, silenced, and you live without condemnation, but instead in the confidence of the Holy Spirit within you. Now, I know as I say this, that lots of people struggle with that. They hear that and they might say, well, Paul, that sounds great. That sounds true. I can see what you're saying. But man, that's a long way from my experience. We've got to change our experience to line up with what the scripture said, instead of what we've tended to do, which is we feel this way, and therefore we start to live out of how we feel. No, live out of what the scripture tells you, and like the word of God tells us, renew your mind, change your thinking. Get the new mind or the new spirit of the mind that the Bible talks about, the spirit of a new mind that comes with Christ. Start to see yourself and think of yourself as a new creation in life union with Jesus and absolutely free from any condemning voice. Those voices might come, tell them to shut up and leave you alone because you are now united with Jesus. I hope that helps you today. God bless you.